evening, esteemed chairperson. Good evening, all. Thank you for choosing to be here post lunch. Well, me along with my co-author Deepthi Swami and me Mridu Sharma from Jain University, Bangalore, India. Both of us PhD scholars under a very beautiful lady out there in pink sari, Dr. Shailaja Shastri. We're here to present something on the Asian climate intervention strategies of intervention in sport and attempting to devise a model out of it. Well, this is an interpretative reflection on and an attempt to develop a model based on my experiences as a sportsman. We definitely, before even me going into the paper and explaining about it, I definitely agree that we need to have an empirical validation to it, which shall be taken by me in stages to come. And going onward, let me talk about, let me just give you a glimpse of how I started this study. We know that sports psychology is exponentially growing in globally. Okay, before I start, how many of you are sportsmen here? Let's have a quick, wow, I have professor there. Anyone else? Just me and professor are the ones who play? Are you sure? Yes, we have so many out there. Let's see if my model, you know, if you would agree with my model or not. Let's keep it open to discussions later, of course. So now, when I was going through the intervention strategies people, sportsmen, sports psychology professionals use, I chanced upon this quote from one of the articles, one of the journals, which says that the person is more important than the sportsman. We all agree. And it is not just about developing the sportsman, it is about developing the person, making the person functional. Now, it says that how superficial it is, if you can see the words they're using, how superficial it is to develop and implement a sports psychology model based around simple performance enhancement strategies. That's a question for us. I was particularly interested in this and moved on to studying a bit about it. And so I went into framing a bit of my framing my objectives for the model, which says the following. So my attempt was basically on developing a framework which is which can be applicable in the practice of Asian consultants. Mainly because of its distinctive cultural background. We know that the Asian climate, Asian perspective has a collectivistic over individualistic culture. We value, because I belong to Asia, we value team over the individual. Cooperation over competition. So on those lines, when I was reading through, I went into going about with the methodology. How do I develop the model? That was a question put forward to me. So the methodology that I worked on were based on levels of inductive and deductive analysis. Wherein, as a researcher, my understanding was what the athletes need from the sport intervention models going into analyzing the studies that have been done on the sport intervention strategies, a meta-analysis wherein establishing, contrasting studies, comparing for relationships, moving on, understanding the climate. Why do I even, I'm concentrating on the Asian climate, which I'll come into a bit in detail, and then moving into a thematic analysis for the development of the model. My results are very simple. Because our concentration was on the whole, holistic self and not on the sportsman, we're talking of the development of the whole person, I chose to apply an approach in my in my model called the humanistic school of thought. We know that the model which I seek to devise is not just based on teaching these skill sets. These skill sets are strategies which most sports psychology professionals use with sports persons, and it has shown positive results in almost all mental health, in general mental health of the population, general population. So it's not just about having them, sportsmen, learn about these skills and for performance enhancement. It's just not tutoring to adapt to, okay, visualize the situation, analyze before you go on to field or play. It's not just about that. It's also, what matters more is about the environment wherein you teach those skills. For that reason, I had chose a humanistic perspective. Because the Asian climate considers the whole person rather the holistic self of an individual, I chose to incorporate these skill sets into a humanistic environment. The humanistic school of thought in sport talks about active participation on the part of the sports people. The coach, the sports psychology professional, is a facilitator, is not a tutor, is a facilitator in the process. And then they go about giving you opportunity, you again, the sports people, opportunity to explore the situation, understand what the situation demands of you, how you should react, adapt to it, and find out the strategies. You can use the skill set, but strategies appropriate for a given situation. In that case, when you talk about active participation, it's actually establishing a very strong, trusting relationship between the athlete and the coach. Coach here again is the sports psychology professional that I'm talking about. And within the humanized sports system, I'm talking about an environment which facilitates those core principles of humanism, namely empathy. All right, is that for me? Is that a cue for me to go on more? Do I get a little longer?
Keep going.
Okay, thank you. So, within the humanized sporting system, we're talking about four core principles which are in play, namely empathy, active listening, congruence and acceptance. Imagine a situation for all the sports people, including me. Imagine a situation when I am with a professional who is a person, a kind of giving me that push to play within that environment wherein I feel that I am not being judged. I am let to explore myself. Again, a humanistic concept. Explore myself, as well as giving me an opportunity to understand how much capable I am to overcome a situation. These are very integral to the concept, to the model that I have devised. However, let's not forget the psychological readiness of sports people. All sports people did not have the same amount of psychological readiness. By that, I mean that not all of us, not all of the sports people would be ready to come into contact with their inner self. They may be overwhelmed. So it is the responsibility of the professional to be the facilitator, to be that, not to hold the hand and take you forward. It's that person behind you and pushing you to go forward. Very integral to the concept of flow that I, let the rat out of the bag. So the concept of flow by Mihaly is extremely important to my model thereafter. The concept of flow that he talks about, and it's about a balance or an integration between the body and mind. When you're aware of the situation, you understand the situation that you have in hand, and you have the expertise, you know that yourself, what you are capable of, with the integration, you have complete control over the situation, which the concept of flow talks about. In that case, it's like an association. You're making an association, or you have that control where Professor Terry spoke about associations between the lyrics and the music. I'm speaking about the association. Again, it's an association between body and mind, wherein, for example, if I'm swimming, I'm in control of the situation. I've become one with my stroke and the water. I know I am in control to push myself up forward. So these are, again, the, please remember that the sports psychology professional is that person who is like the like a support behind facilitating the process. I'd just like to end by saying that there is a lot of debate or kind of gap between theory and practice. So application. So we shall try to, as I said, that this is extremely important, that my theory, which is a reflective proposition right now, goes into a validation process. Not just in Asia, I regard the application of this model in Western countries too. Let's see how it goes. Let's see if it at all fits into the practice of professional sports psychology there. As written here, and you can read it, it goes beyond what exists. So I'm just kind of exploring. This is an attempt again to explore something beyond something what exists, and not just in Asia but also in Western countries that I would love to look into. Thank you so much.
Meta-analysis is the analysis of the analysis. Whatever the studies are done with respect to your topic concern,
yes,
that your task is to collect the data from previous, and then you have to conclude. What is that process, my question?
Yes. So I did have conclusions on my strategies, which I had put it up. So I had done meta-analysis in the initial stages, wherein I drew conclusions from those studies and came up with the basis for the framework from where I developed my model, which again will go for a meta-analysis.
Very much.
Thank you, madam.